Bueno, lo que estamos viendo es a LP en vivo desde Moscú, que es su más reciente disco y que, bueno, pues ahora lo está presentando. Y para mí es de verdad un enorme, enorme orgullo y felicidad poder platicar con ella. Aquí la tengo virtualmente vía Zoom. LP, I'm so glad to have you here.
Virtually, thank you. Of course, yes,
via Zoom. And I'm so happy to present your new production live from Moscow. How are you?
Thank you so much. I'm good. I'm here in LA, just chilling. I'm just doing what they say, stay home. Kind of trying to, just writing music, hanging out, doing my thing, waiting to go on tour again. And I felt like that was why we released this live album, so we can feel close. It's a way of feeling close to fans while we're like, you know, everybody's locked down right now.
Yeah, me too. I'm locked down right now because I'm just being diagnosed and positive of coronavirus.
I'm sorry to hear that.
Yeah, well,
are you no symptoms though? No, asymptomatic, no symptoms.
First day, yes, I had, but right now I'm taking all the meds and I'm feeling great. I'm feeling good. Okay. So I'm working. Good. I'm making this
interview.
Well, that's
good. And I'm so then you'll be immune. Yeah, me too. I'm happy too. But then you won't have to worry about getting it later. That's good.
Yeah. So excuse me if they it's say. Not the best interview you had in your life. That's
because this is the best interview I've had in my life.
It's like being 1 minute. That's weird. Thank you very much, LP, for having you in here.
Thank you.
Now we're talking about coronavirus. You have been a fighter against all kind of discrimination and all kind of prejudices, and people all around the world that are getting sick are also facing prejudices. And even in my country, for instance, the healthcare personnel. So discrimination and hate, it's unacceptable everywhere, in any kind and any presentation. Yeah. And right now, this is the worst.
It's not the worst. It's always been here, you know. It's just come to the forefront of people's attention. And you know, this has been centuries in the making, you know. A lot of all of this, you know, as far as discrimination goes, it's, you know, it's just an ongoing thing that we've allowed, you know, so we don't have to deal with it. And so we need to deal with it. And, you know, I hope that in my country in particular, we can, you know, we're beginning, like only at the very beginning of a dialogue that needs to like consistently and constantly happen.
Like, you are fighting so much. I'm so proud of the work you are doing, not only with your music and your messages, but with your activism. I have been your follower since, like, I don't know how many times. Yeah, I'm a big fan of you, of yours and your work. And
Thank you. Right now,
for instance, what is happening with the Floyd affair in the U.S. has been like that's a good thing because it's a kind of consciousness.
Yeah,
that you don't have to discriminate people because of their race.
It's unacceptable. I mean, it always has been, and it is like, you know, like right now, it's like, you know, a person, you know, a white person like myself, I have to, you know, just be really careful and conscious of like my lack of experience firsthand of this discrimination, and just try to listen and learn and get to, you know, allow people to teach me, you know, how I can help and, you know, and what I can do. So it's, you know, it's tough because you're used to like being like, I'm going to do something about it, you know, but there's everything to do and nothing to do immediately. You know, you have to find out where you're best serving. Yeah. And where you're going to put your energies.
So Moscow.
Yeah.
I can guess why. Because it's a political statement. It's a
it's just
statement.
A cool place. Have you been there?
It's Vladimir Putin. It's hate.
But you know, when you grow up in America, and you know, you're always hearing of, you know, the Cold War and you know, like the Soviet Union and everything that's been like kind of built up as far as making Russia like cut off from other people, from other countries, and you know, and at you know, at odds. You know, I think that's like those, they're political.
Like Mexico and Latin America in general, are so conservative in so many ways. And perhaps in the name of love, parents in this country do not accept their kids when they are becoming out and they are saying, "Mom, Dad, guess what, I'm gay." And that's in the name of love, they begin to reject them. What would you say to that parents?
You know, I would say that ultimately, you know, yes, you can make someone do what you want, maybe. You know, maybe you can shame your child into, you know, not living their truth, or even like, you know, just guilt them into it. But I think there's so many things that are going to come from that are going to lead to unhappiness, a lesser quality of life for the person. I think that, you know, you have to really think about what is the thing you're ultimately afraid of. You know, I think, you know, not to get, I think that, you know, when you get down to it, like, should you really know the intimate details of your child's sex life anyway? You know what I'm saying? Like, if they're with a person of the same sex and it's a, you know, it's a straight, you know, normal relationship, are you thinking about the sexual life of your child? You know, you're not really, so.
You have been singing with one of our dearest singers,
yes.
Mariñana, one of her songs. That was
Yeah, great. She's the best. You liked it?
Yeah.
I love it, yeah. She's such a wonderful, down-to-earth.
For the Latin community in the U.S.
Yeah, oh, right on, yeah. You know, I feel like the divide has been lessening and lessening with the Latin music and American music. So I feel like every little bit keeps adding to that.
Your guitar near to you. So I was wondering if you're gonna make a little bit a cappella here for us.
Oh my gosh, it's a different guitar, but yeah. What do you want to hear? You want to hear a little something?
Oh, your most famous one, Lost on You. It's wonderful.
All right, let's see. There you go. My guitar is out of tune.
Wow. LP, I'm so grateful. I'm amazed to have you here.
I can't wait. I miss Mexico so much. It's like literally one of my favorite places on earth. So I can't wait to get back. Thank you.
And I'll be waiting for you, hopefully.
Yeah, yeah.